Hello everyone, I am Sarita Rawat, Assistant Professor, School of Pharmacy, Suresh Kam Vihar University, Jaipur, Rajasthan. Today we will start our next lecture of pharmacology, and today's our next topic is chronopharmacology. Learning objective of today's lecture is introduction, history, definition, circadian rhythm and clock genesis, application of chronopharmacology, chronopharmacotherapeutics, conclusion and reference. Now, learning outcome of today's lecture included, upon completion of this lecture, you are able to know about circadian rhythm, clock genesis, application of chronopharmacology and chronopharmacotherapeutics. Now, we will start from our introductory part. So, introduction of chronopharmacology included most facts of the mammalian physiology and behavior vary according to time to the day, time of the day, and thanks to an endogenesis circadian clock. Daily oscillation of proteins is necessary for either drug absorption or metabolism result in the circadian pharmacokinetics, and the oscillation in the physiological system that tends by these drugs result in the circadian pharmacodynamics. Circadian clock influence all major organ system, and this influence the translates directly into disease pathology that also varies with time of the day. Now, talking about the history of the chemopharmacotherapy, so it included, it start from the Jean Jacques D. Alters D. Marin. He described the circadian rhythm of the plant in the 18th century. And then after that, French Halberg coined the term circadian in 20th century. Circa is about of approximately day or about of the 24th hour. They considered as one of the founder of modern chronobiology. So as you can see, we have also added some picture of the scientist Jean Jacques D. Alters D. Marin and the French Halberg, which is also who is also now considered as the founder of modern chronobiology. Now, talking about the biological rhythm, so we have classified the biological rhythm according to the different criteria. Talking about the circadian rhythm, so it is lasting for the about 24 hours, and which is also a sleep wake cycle. Then next we have infraradian cycle. Infraradian rhythm, so it is a cycle longer than 24 hours, which is also known as menstrual cycle. Then we have ultraradian, so it is a cycle shorter than a day, which is neurological flirting time. Then we have a seasonal cycle, seasonal rhythm, so it is a seasonal affective disorder. Talking about the biorhythm, so as you can see, we have categorized the rhythm according to the time. So talking about the ultraradian, so it is the time less than 24 hours. Then we have circadian time. It is the time approximately for 24 hours. Then we have infraradian. Infraradian is the time more than 24 hours. Then we have circaseptan. So circaseptan is the time of 7 days. Then the circadiseptan. Circadiseptan is the time of 14 days. Then we have circavaya jaitin. So it is the time of 21 days. Then we have circa tai janatil. So it is the time for 30 days. And then we have circa annual. So it is the time of 1 year. So this is our biological rhythm that is categorized according to the time, day, year. Now, the next we have definitions. So when we talk about the chronobiology, so it is the branch of science that focus on the biological rhythm and their mechanism. Like we have chronos. So chronos means time, bios means life, and logos means study. So chronobiology means the study of the time and study of the life according to the time. Now, chronopharmacology. So chronopharmacology is the science which deal with the optimization of drug effect and minimization of the adverse effect by timing medications in relations to the biological rhythm. And it is concerned with the effect of drug upon the timing of the biological event and rhythms. And it is also subdivided into pharmacokinetics, chronotoxicology, chronotoxicity, chronoacetacy, chronotherapy. Now it deals with the study of the temporal changes in the chronopharmacokinetics, and chronopharmacokinetics of the it is also known as the study of the chronopharmacokinetics of the drug with respect to the time. And the study of absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion of the drug according to the time of the day of the year. Now, next we have chrononasathy. So it is the rhythmic changes in the susceptibility or sensitivity of a target system to a drug. Next, we have chrononarasy. So it is the rhythmic changes of the both the desired effectiveness and the undesired toxicity or tolerance effects on the organism as a whole. Now, next we have chronotherapeutics. So it is a discipline of medical treatment which allow for the consideration of a patient's biological rhythm, changes in the severity of a disease, state during the day, and the synchronizing of the dosing and delivery of a particular drug to allow for the optimal efficacy in the patient. It refers to concept of a matching timing of treatment with intrinsic timing of the illness. The advantage of the chronotherapeutics are it prevents the overdosing, it has appropriate use of the drug, and it reduces the side effect in patients also. So it is very important. As you can see, its advantage is like very important, and its advantage is very favorable to the patient. Now, next we have chronopharmaceutics. So chronopharmaceutics is the branch which designs and develop a drug delivery system in accordance with the biological rhythm to optimize the treatment of the disease. So as you can see, the circadian rhythm. So circadian rhythm is the basic unit of circadian timekeeping, is the suprachiasmatic nucleus and the clock genesis. So this is, as you can see, it is regulated by the cerebral cortex, pineal gland, hypothalamus, and optic opticism. Now the next we have jet gabber. So jet gabber is the circadian rhythm are driven by the endogenous process and are self-sustaining and relay upon the circadian time sources jet gabbers to remain appropriately oriented to the individual's environment and desired routine. So this is the circadian clock. So it is the external 24-hour light day cycle, and that is the photozabber, and then it is the eye that is for environment, and the endogenous circadian rhythm, which is SCN and master clock. Then the synchronizations between the then we have non-phatric Zbar. So it is sleep wake cycle, physical activity, social time, and meals. Now the next term we have clock genesis. So clock genesis is the circadian rhythm are driven by a group of genesis called clock genesis. In mammals, the core clock genesis consists of BMAL1 brain and muscles aryl hydrocarbon receptor nuclear translocator like one. It is and also the clock CLOCK, which donates the circadian locomotor output cycles capped. And then we have PR for the period and CRY for the cryptochrome, and they form a tightly regulated system with interlocking feedback and feed forward loops. So as you can see, this is the cryptoplast and this is the output, and which included the nucleus also. So BMAL1, then clock, and it goes to the nucleus, and then it becomes BMAL1 and clock. Then we have the different kind of like PR, CRY, ROR, RVZ and CCG. So you can easily look out that. And then the output we have PER, CRY, ROR and REV and ERB. Now, when we talk about the human circadian time structure, so this is the night and daytime structure for human. So when we talk about the daytime, so it included gastric acid secretion, calcitonin gene-related peptides, and then we have neutrophils, acid phosphatase, uric acid secretions, triglyceride, cholesterol, insulin, serum total proteins, hemoglobins, testosterone, angiotensin, catecholamines. So these are the daytime regulators. Then when we talk about the night time, so at that time TSH, IDR, natriuretic peptide, growth hormone, lymphocytes, prolactin, melatonin, eosinophils, ACTH, FSH and LH more likely to be secreted, cholesterol and aldosterone also. So this is the human circadian time structure, which goes related according to the day and night time, and also the hormones that secrete into the body, human body, it's also depend upon the day and night cycle. As such, like we can see, the growth hormones are more active at the night time, and in the daytime uric acid secretion is more active. So these according to the human circadian time structure, we can also regulate the disease, we can also go through the disease cure. Now you can see this is the peptic ulcer disease exacerbations. So as you can see, in the night and day cycle, at the start of the day cycle, so the epileptic seizure raised, chronic pain, then the dermatostosis occur, osteoarthritis chances increases, hemorrhagic and perforated ulcer crisis improved, sickle cell anemia crisis improved, then the angina, acute myocardial infarction, sudden cardiac death, hemorrhagic or thrombotic stroke chances increase, then migraine, headache, allergic, infectious, rhinitis, rheumatoid arthritis chances occur, then the epileptic seizures chances at the 6 p.m. night time, then also the asthmatic conditions, and then the prionyl methyl angina conditions increase, apnea conditions increase, CHF conditions increase at the night time, and also the peptic ulcer decrease. Disease exhibitions chances increased at the night time. So you can distinguish between the day and night time, and the chances of the disease that occur at the particular time of the day and the night. So you can see it, and according to that you can treat the you can take the medications. According to that you can follow the therapeutic effect also. Now, next we can start with the applications of chronopharmacology, where the chronopharmacology is effective. So, in the respiratory system, it is very important. It play a very important. So, it in increased bronchoconstriction at night due to increase in the parasympathetic tone, decrease in the adrenaline, decrease in the cholesterol at midnight, increased sensitivity to the irritants and allergens at the night time, and the balance between the exacerbations of the allergic rhinitis and asthma. So according to this, we can design the medications and we can stable the patient according to the these rhythmic conditions. Now, in asthma, acute attack of the asthma may occur, and more common between midnight and at the 6 a.m. And for the medications, theophylline and beta 2 agonist is timed at evening. Then, as you can see, this is the CVS nighttime dip. So this is blood pressure at midnight, this is time, sleep, and the systolic blood pressure, then diastolic blood pressure threshold. Now in the morning time it raises, and as you can see, this is the blood pressure measurement according to the time, and this is the sleep cycle. So you can see the this wave, this is like increasing and decreasing according to the time. Now, next is the its effect is in cardiovascular disorders. So, as you can see, it can be effective in the myocardial infarctions, sudden cardiac death, angina pectoris, transient ischemic attack, strokes, high incidence between 6 a.m. and 12 noon, and it increases the vascular tone and platelet aggregations and decrease the intrinsic thrombocytic activity. And also the cardiovascular drug, we have aspirin, that maximum antiplatelet effect in the morning, and thrombocytes and heparin decrease the benefit during early morning hours. Then atenolol, more effective during daytime, and labetalol, more effective in early morning hours. Then in enalapril, peak effective in the afternoon after morning dose. Then other application in the endocrine system. So highest secretion of the cholesterol early morning, lowest at the midnight, and GH peak during the sleep, and testosterone peak early morning, TSH peak at the midnight. Corticosteroid given as a single monitoring dose causes less pituitary adrenal suspension. Now, in the gastrointestinal tract, acid secretion peak between 10 p.m. and 2 a.m. Ulcer pain is worst at this time. Ulcer healing is directly related to the acid secretion inhibitions at night, and the evening dose of H2 receptor antagonist or protein pump inhibitor. Then in the CNS, melatonin secreted at the night by the pineal gland, and the function is synchronized sleep-wake cycle with the circadian rhythm and melatonin agonist, that is remelatin, hypnotic for the sleep onset insomnia, and it reduce jet lag symptoms also. Bedtime administration is more effective. Now we have musculoskeletal system. So in rheumatoid arthritis, symptoms more severe at 8 a.m. and 11 a.m. and long acting NSAIDs at the bedtime. Then osteoarthritis, pain more intense between 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. and morning does for afternoon versus evening dose for the nighttime versus. Now in the hypercholesterolemia, in the cholesterol synthesis more at the nighttime, and even dose of the HMG and coenzyme reductase inhibitor is more effective. And in cancer cells are considered to have lost internal time keeping mechanism. Tumor cell and normal cell differ in their chronobiological cycles. Then the basis for the chronopharmacotherapy of the cancer, like in lymphoma, so the DNA synthesis is the normal human bone marrow cells and has a peak round node, while the peak of the DNA synthesis in lymphoma cells is near midnight. So as an S-phase active cytotoxic therapy at the late night should be more advantageous. And the next in the skin disorder, so the psoriasis cell proliferations rate peak between 9 p.m. and the 3 a.m. And inflammatory activity highest at the night and it is least in the morning. Then when we talk about the atopic dermatitis, so sensitivity to the histamine is the highest at nighttime, and topical corticosteroid activity in the afternoon higher than that in the morning. Now, chronopharmacotherapeutics. So, chronopharmacotherapeutics is mainly design and development of chrono drugs delivery system. So, when we talk about the circadian rhythm, so biological process and psychological process, behavioral process are included. Then, chronopharmacology and chronopharmacokinetics, chronopharmacodynamics are involved in that. Then, chronopharmacotherapeutics concept involved in that. Then, when we take drugs, so chronotropic drugs delivery strategy occurs. Then functional designing and formulation designing take part, process designing take part, and packaging designing take part in that quality. And then after that we make a quality by the design. Then when we talk about the chronopharmacotherapeutic chronopharmaceutical product, so it includes the optimal dosing time and the time control and site control. Then it compliances include ideal chronotherapy, QOL, and side effect and efficacy. Efficacy is increased and side effect decreased. So the design, this is the design and development of new chronotropic DDS in the accordance with the circadian rhythm. So this is the design and development of chrono drug delivery system. Now these are the chrono drug delivery system we have. Chronons, chrono DDS. So it included MS Conchi morphine sulfate controlled release tablets, RX only 100 tablets, and then the next one we have is diffuse capsules, which has bed technology, and it has core granules or crystals, then protective coating or additional control polymers, drug layers, and releasing control polymers. So you can easily see it. So we have, for example, OROS, OODS, and CEFORM, Timex polymers. Now, this is the oral administration morning or bedtime. So this is an ideal chronotherapeutic drug delivery according to the circadian rhythm disorder to the patient. So you can see this is the lag time. So it is here, the peak time is here, and then the chrono control time, you can see it. circadian rhythm disorder. So this is the circadian rhythm disorder, and this is the chronotype delivery system. So this is the chronotype delivery system, and it is better in the control chrono control time and the condition of the disease, and then worsen in the worsen without the chrono control time. So this is the oral administration morning or at the bedtime. Now next we have chronopharmaceuticals technology. So we have parenteral route in the chronotherapy include chronomodulating infusions pump, modulate, and then we have Melody, and then Panomet, V5, Synchromite, and Rheumatite. Then we have controlled release microchips, so which include oral administration include Quantin, Onset, Kudas, Cefom, Diffucaps, Timex, Chronotopic, Atlet, Geoglo, Prot, 3-dimensional printing, 3DPP also called it. Then method involve psychophysiochemical modification of an active pharmaceutical ingredient and or the use of controlled released aerodiable polymers. Now pulsatile drug delivery system we have, so which include here a targeted drug is delivered at the specific site due to the inductions of certain physiochemical stimuli at the target site, and the release of certain enzyme, hormones, antibodies, pH of the site, temperature of the site, presence of the certain cells, and concentrations of the biomolecule, which is like glucose and neurotransmitters and inflammatory mediators, act as a stimuli to target to trigger the release of drug from these type of drug delivery systems. And recently a novel floating pulsatile system introduced, and it has high internal phase emulsions based porous material. Then these are some marketed technologies of pulsatile drug delivery system. So as you can see, we have the technology and its mechanism, property, proprietary name and doses form, and then the API included in that, and which disease it is used for. So when we talk about the OROS system, so it is the osmotic, mechanism include osmotic mechanism, then the proprietary name and doses form is Covera HS, and it is Excel tablet. Then API is a verapamil HCl, then disease it is used in the hypertension. Then we have CODOS, so it has the mechanism multi particulate dependent system, and the doses form it is in the varilin PM XL release capsule, and the API is verapamil HCl, and the disease in the hypertension. Then we have Diffucaps, so it is the its mechanism is multi-particulate system. Then the property name and the doses form is Inopren XL tablet, and API is Verapamil HCl and Propranolol HCl, and used in the hypertension. Then we have 3-dimensional printing, so it is mechanism is externally regulated system. And the proprietary name and doses form is Thiofarm, and then the API is diclofenic sodium, and it is used in the inflammation. Then we have Pulsinacap, so it is mechanism included ruptorable system, and then the property name and doses form, so Pulsinacap PM. And the API included is dofetilide, and used in the hypertension. So the conclusion of all the chronopharmacology included, it is effectiveness and the toxicity of a drug are not constant over 24-hour period, and understanding the biological rhythm can optimize and individualize the drug therapy to a great extent, and thus it can help to decrease the drug-related toxicity, and also it enhance the effectiveness of the doses form, and it is very useful in the pharmaceutical system. So when we talk about the chronopharmacology, so we can say it is very it is important, and it play a great role in the treatment of a disease, and it can give a good result and decrease the side effect in the patient, but it has lots of side effects also. So we do not tell that we have to go through the chronopharmacology. So when we talk about chronopharmacology, so we have concluded that pharmacology chronotherapy is developing science that holds much hope for increasing the effectiveness of the drug therapy and for reducing the incidence of toxic drug reactions, and there is convincing scientific work in the incidence that more attention should be given to the time of the drug administration, and most prescribable are currently more considered with what to prescribe rather than when to prescribe it. So chronopharmacotherapy currently holds the promises for certain of the most favorable conditions for the drug and drug effect and its safety, and there represent an important method to improving the treatment of many diseases, and the global chronopharmacotherapeutics is to optimize the therapeutic effect and control to reduce the adverse effect of the drug, and that altering the function of the drug in the body. So in that manner, chronopharmacology is very important, and also it is the science that considered with the variation in the pharmacological action of the various drug over a biological timing and endogenous period. So we can say it give more better result when going according to that. And we have also studied about the circadian rhythm. So it is the oscillation in the biological and physiological behavior function of the organism, which for the periodic of 24 hours. But we cannot say that we have to follow blindly in the circadian rhythm. So sometimes we have to go beyond that. Now we have concluded some questions, some quiz questions related to the circadian rhythm. So you can definitely check out these questions. So these questions are related to the circadian rhythm. So as you know, chronopharmacology is the very important topic, and patient got good result according to this. So some questions related to the chronopharmacology we have, what is chronopharmacology and what are the types of chronopharmacology we have, and also the question included what is chronopharmacology, give types of chronopharmacology, and how circadian rhythm works, and how many types of circadian rhythm, how many types of biological clock we have, how many types of ultraradian we have. So you can easily answer these questions going through this lecture. So as you can see, we have some lots of questions related to the chronopharmacology. What is chronopharmacology and what do you understand by chronopharmacology? What is the significance of the biological clock and how do you test circadian rhythm? What is the significance of biological clock and how do you test for the circadian rhythm? What gland is called late biological clock and how do you do a chronotherapy? So these are the questions that we have concluded from this particular lecture. So if you go through this lecture very deeply, so you can answer all these questions very easily. So we will go through just a quick review of these questions so that you can go you can get good answers. So as you can know, the circadian rhythms various systems we have, like cardiovascular systems and respiratory system, endocrine system, and then plasma protein binding system and liver enzyme systems we have. So according to them, we can follow their that. And when we talk about the chronotherapy of the disease, so we have in bronchial asthma, so the drug we can use according to the chronotherapy. So we have corticosteroid, theophylline, and otribiol. In cardiovascular disease, we can use aspirin, then heparin, atenol, and in cancer, we can use cisplatin and doxorubicin. So all these are according to the chronotherapy. And when we talk about the application of chronopharmacology, so the application we have, because it minimizes the dose of the drug and getting the optimum benefits of the drug with minimum toxicities and opening a new venue in the therapy of allopathic drug also, and individualizing the medical treatment. And then when we talk about the basic part of the chronopharmacology, so chronopharmacology is very useful to save problems of the drug optimizations and also enhance the desired efficacy or to reduce its undesired effect. And in humans organ, the metabolic fate of the pharmacologic agent is not like constant for the function of the time. So the chronobiology chronobiologic approach of the pharmacological phenomena involve a lesser risk of the errors and the false informations than the conventional homeostatic approach. So this is all about your chronopharmacology and the questions related to the chronopharmacology. Now we have some references that we have concluded for this lecture. So the reference included Moria KK et al. Chronopharmacology, a tool for therapy of disease, IRJP 2012. And then we have Yon BBC, a chronopharmaceutical drug delivery system, Cordless, Hype and Hope, Advanced Drug Delivery Reviews in 2010. Then we have Chelling L and Young G, Recent Advances in Circadian Rhythm in Cardiovascular System. Then we have next V.S. Chopra et al. Chronotherapy, a Novel Concept in Drug Delivery, Pharmacia Latria in 2010. So you can definitely check out these book, these references for further knowledge of the chronopharmacology. So we have just learned about the chronotherapy, and according to the chronotherapy, the patient conditions we can cure it. So this is all about today's lecture. We will go through a quick revise for this lecture so that you can recall everything very easily. So today we have started from the basics. So most factors of the mammalian psychology and behavioral vary according to the time of the day. So thanks to an endogenous circadian clock that we know all about it, then the daily oscillation of the proteins is very necessary for either drug absorption or the metabolism result in the circadian pharmacokinetics and the oscillation in the physiological system that targeted by the these drugs result in the circadian pharmacodynamics. And circadian clocks influence all major organism system, and it influence the translates directly into the disease pathology that also varies with the time of day. Then we have also studied about the history of the chronopharmacology. So Jane Jacobs D. Alters D. Marin is the he has described the circadian rhythm of the plant in 18th century. Then we have French Halberg. He coined the term circadian in 20th century. Circa means about or approximately day or about 24 hours, and he was considered as one of the founder of modern chronobiology. Now then when we have talked about the biological rhythm, so we have circadian rhythm, infraradiant rhythm, ultraradiant rhythm, and seasonal rhythm. So we have biorhythm, so which is according to the time and day and year. So ultraradian is the less than 24 hours, circadian is 24 hour period, and then infraradiant more than 24 hour, then circaseptor is the 7-day time period, then circadiseptor is a 14-day period, and then circavisanatin is the 21-day period, and then circatrizanatin is 30-day period, and then circaannual is the 1 year of time period. Then we have talk about the definition. So chronobiology, chronos means time, bios means life, and logos means study. So it is the branch of science focusing on the biological rhythm and their mechanism. So chronopharmacology is the science that deal with the optimization of the drug effect and minimization of the adverse effect by timing medications in relations to the biological rhythm, and it is considered with the effect of the drug upon the timing of the biological event and rhythms, and it is subdivided into chronopharmacokinetics and chronotoxicity. So chronoesthesia and chronotherapy. Then we have talk about the chrononarcy. So it is the rhythmic changes of the both the desired and undesired effect on the organism as a whole. Then we talk about the chronotherapeutics. So it is the discipline of medicine, medical treatment, which allow for the consideration of a patient biological rhythm and changes in the severity of a disease state during the day, and synchronizing of dosing and delivery of a particular drug to allow for the optimal efficacy in the patient. And it refers to the context of concept of matching timing or treatment with intrinsic timing of the illness. And the advantage of chronopharmacotherapeutics is prevents overdosing, appropriate using of the drug, and reduce the side effect. Then we talk about the chronopharmaceutics. So it is the branch which deals and which designs and develops a drug delivery system in accordance with the biological rhythm to optimize the treatment of disease. Then we have talked about the circadian rhythm. So it is the basic unit of circadian timekeeping is the suprachiasmatic nucleus and clock genesis. Then we talk about the Jedburgh. So this is the circadian rhythms are driven by the endogenous process and are self-sustaining and rely upon circadian time causes and to remain appropriately oriented to the individual's environment and desired routine. Now we have clock genesis. We have studied about the clock genesis, then human circadian time structures. Then applications of chronopharmacology. So it is in the respiratory system. So increased bioconstructions at the night due to the increase in parasympathetic tune and decrease in adrenaline and decrease in cholesterol at the midnight and increased sensitivity of irritants and allergens at the night. Then we have talked about the asthma, acute attack of asthma, and more common between the midnight and 6 a.m. And the drug we used for the asthma cure is theophylline and beta 2 agonist is time at the evening. Then CVS night time tape. So this is the paragraph. This is the graph we have. And then the morning raise times. Then for the cardiovascular disorder, endocrine system we have studied, in gastrointestinal we have studied, in CNS we have studied, mucoskeletal system. Then in osteoarthritis, so pain is more intense between 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. Then in cancer, so cancer cells are considered to have lost internal time keeping mechanism, and tumor cell and more cell differ in their chronobiological cycles. Then we have also studied about the skin disorders, so psoriasis, cell proliferation rate peaks between 9 p.m. to 3 a.m. Then chronopharmacotherapeutics we have studied. So this is all about today your chronopharmacotherapy. So you can check out these references also. Thank you for today's lecture. Thank you for kindly listening to me. Thank you.